Hey guys, welcome to the video. So today I am going to be tackling a topic that is very much in the forefront of the news right now as it pertains to the live event industry. One of you guys actually commented on my video yesterday and asked me to address Ticketmaster's new plans to safely bring back large-scale events and concerts next year. This is obviously a topic I've been following very closely. I am a massive fan of live events and music festivals, so any talk about them coming back next year, I'm all for it. So today I'm gonna break down this news, let you know everything that's going on and the current plans that Ticketmaster has to do this safely. And then at the end of the video, I'll give you guys my final thoughts. The comments are open, so please chime in down below with your thoughts and opinions. Keep it nice in the comments, please, and respect everybody. All right, so let's just jump into this. So basically what has happened is Ticketmaster has come out with their plans for 2021 to bring events back safely by checking show attendees' vaccine status or test results from COVID prior to them attending an event. So let's back it up here for a second. So where we're at currently right now in November 2020, we just got word from Pfizer that they have a viable vaccine candidate that is 90% effective for the coronavirus. And from what I've read, they're saying right now it would be two shots or two injections that you would be getting for the vaccine. According to the New York Times, if Pfizer receives authorization for this vaccine from the Food and Drug Administration, the company in theory could vaccinate millions of Americans by the end of this year, taking advantage of months of planning and decades of experience. So that sent shockwaves everywhere, right? I mean, we're all holding our breath here waiting to find out how we're gonna get through this and how we're gonna be able to return to our normal lives. And I think the timeline has been all over the place. We were thinking maybe next year, and you know, I'm sitting here waiting for events to come back as soon as possible, and of course, as safe as possible. So because of that news, obviously live event production companies are starting to gear up for their 2021 and start to project when they're gonna be able to have concerts and large scale events. So where does this leave us in 2021? How soon can events start to happen? And how soon can this vaccine be distributed to millions of Americans? I know in the EDM community and the festival industry, we've seen them playing around with live streams and then in real life drive-in events. I've also seen some events do rapid testing where you drive up, you get tested, you have to wait in your car until you get a negative test result, and then you gain entry into the event. So that's kind of been some of the things that have been happening. I've also seen events taking the approach next year, saying that they're gonna do limited capacity. So Ubby Dubby Festival plans to happen in April 2021 in Texas. And right now it says they are reducing their festival capacity to 50%. But how can we take it a step further and be even safer? This is what Ticketmaster plans to do. Also, really quick disclaimer before we get into this, I'm not gonna discuss my belief on vaccines. I don't wanna get into a debate about it. If medical professionals and my doctor say that it's safe to take this vaccine and obviously the trials and everything is approved, I would feel comfortable taking the vaccine so that I can return to my normal life and I can go about life safely and see my family members and friends and be able to do things again. So that's my personal stand on this vaccine. Okay, so let's get into Ticketmaster's framework. They announced that they are gonna be looking for two things. One, that you've been vaccinated, or two, that you have tested negative for COVID within a 24 to 72 hour window from the event. And that depends on the state that you live in. So the number one thing is you are gonna need to download the Ticketmaster app, which was very smart play for them. But that's how you're obviously gonna show your ticket before you attend an event and how you're gonna show that you are safe, you're COVID free, or you're vaccinated. The number two thing you're gonna have to do is share your health information with Clear Health Pass and IBM's Digital Health Pass. And then the testing or the vaccine distribution can either be done through like CVS's health clinic or LabCorp. And that's according to billboard.com. Obviously in the future, there might be more vaccination distribution places that you can go to that Ticketmaster has approved, but we're gonna have to wait and see what happens with that. This is really important to note. According to Ticketmaster, they will reportedly not store or access your medical records under this plan. They will just be accessing your test results and if you've been vaccinated. Okay, so basically what they're saying is you need to get vaccinated or you need to test negative in this window and you need to be comfortable sharing those results with the app. I know for a lot of people this raises red flags, they're nervous about data privacy and things like that, but honestly, if you use the internet and you're on social media, your data privacy is already out there, so it just depends on your comfort level. And obviously, if you are a fan of concerts and live events, you're gonna kinda have to weigh the pros and cons for yourself. Okay, so now I wanna break down how this would work step by step. So again, number one, you would purchase your tickets to an event through Ticketmaster, and obviously they do concerts, they do live event performances, and they have sports as well. So Ticketmaster obviously covers a whole bunch of live events. Again, number two, you're gonna have to verify that you've either been vaccinated or that you've tested negative within a 24 to 72 hour window, and again, that's gonna depend from state to state. And according to Billboard.com, the length of coverage a test would provide would be governed by regional health authorities. If attendees of a Friday night concert had to be tested 48 hours in advance, most of them could start the testing process the day before the event. If it was a 24-hour window, most people would likely be tested the same day of the event at a lab or health clinic. So we're talking about a quick turnaround here. Okay, so once you've been tested, you would then give the lab your results, and then they would share that with the companies Ticketmaster has approved, like IBM and Clear Health Pass. And then lastly, those companies would then give your results to Ticketmaster and share that you've tested negative or that you've been vaccinated. And then you would be allowed entry into the event. I know it sounds like a lot, but hopefully that process would be pretty quick. One of the many questions I have is, what happens if you test positive? Do you get a refund right away? Like, how are they gonna handle that ticketing process? Because that obviously could be an issue that they run into pretty frequently. And again, it's a little upsetting as a fan if you buy tickets and the day of the event you test positive and then that's wiped from your calendar. Obviously, people's health is way more important than a concert. I'm not saying it isn't, but I'm just saying it's gonna be a quick turnaround, so you're gonna know one way or the other very quickly. I also just wanna read this quickly because I think it's very important. Ticketmaster would not store or have access to fans' medical records and would only receive verification of whether a fan is cleared to attend an event on a given date. Different states will have different requirements. The main role of companies like HealthPass companies will be to collect data from testing and medical providers and deliver the status updates to partner companies in a secure, encrypted way that complies with the Health Insurance Portability and Accountability Act, HIPAA. So again, people who are nervous, this is not accessing any other medical records. They're not gonna know everything about your life. They're just gonna know your test results. Okay, now that I've gotten all that out of the way, I wanna talk about some other important things to note about this whole framework and process. Okay, so this whole process going through third-party technology has not officially been approved by the Food and Drug Administration just yet. So that is not a finalized process. They still have to get all of that approved. Another thing, just in general, that Ticketmaster is looking to do in the future is obviously speed up the process of digital ticketing. So they kind of want to erase the idea of people having printed tickets. This kind of connects a fan and your profile to your ticket. I would say in the past, I don't know, a couple of years, I've always done digital tickets. It's just so much easier just to scan it and get in, but that's something they're gonna look to move away from in the future. Another thing that's in play, it says Ticketmaster also plans to deploy its new smart event system, which helps event organizers and fans manage social distancing, delayed entry, and provide possible opportunities for contact tracing. Many of the safety parameters will be set by regional health officials and event organizers, and event organizers also have the ability to set their own prevention protocols like sanitation, mask compliance, and social distancing. So depending on the venue you're going to and the state you're in, it might vary state to state. So if all of this happens, if all of this is successful and it's approved and it goes well, this is huge for the live event industry, right? Again, Ticketmaster does not just do small concerts, they do festivals, they do live event performances, shows, and sporting events. So that is a very, very big deal if this goes well. All right, guys, I just want to give you my final thoughts before I wrap this whole thing up. So as a fan of live events, concerts, music festivals, sporting events, I would love nothing more. Nothing more than to have them come back, especially early next year, maybe spring, and I would love nothing more to have all of these people have their jobs back. This live event industry is suffering. It's extremely sad to see local venues shutting, people out of work, and I know so many people had to be furloughed from these companies. So I would love nothing more than for events to come back safely. That's first and foremost. Number two, this is gonna be up to you personally and what you feel comfortable doing. I personally feel comfortable sharing that information. If it is just what they say, sharing your test results or sharing that you've been vaccinated, I do not mind sharing that through an app to Ticketmaster if that means that I can go back to shows and music festivals. And then also have peace of mind that everybody else there has tested negative or has been vaccinated, so you're not stressing out the entire time thinking about if somebody else could be sick around you. Also, if this goes well, again, I wanna bring up Ubby Dubby as an example, saying that they're gonna be at 50% capacity. It's an outdoor event as well. I wonder if this can all happen, then can we have full-scale events come back at once and not have these small-scale events or limited capacity or socially distant events or not even have indoor events? If this process does work as it's stated, I would love to attend a concert indoors next year or be able to go to a festival that's at max capacity. I think that would be absolutely amazing. I might just be really hopeful right now, but again, we'll see what happens. My only other concern that I want to bring up is travel. So say you buy tickets to an event that's out of state, or maybe you need to fly to it. Say you test negative 48 hours in advance, you travel and you attend the event. What if you got COVID in the process of traveling, whether on a plane or in a bathroom, however you get it, you don't have symptoms yet and you attend this event? That's the only area that I get a little bit hung up on. So I think that's just something that's up in the air. That testing window, you're gonna have to really make sure that that's the safest way possible and that these tests, because I know I've heard things about rapid tests not having like the most accurate results. So again, these are just some questions I'm shooting out loud that I personally have. Alrighty, you guys, that is the end of this video. Thank you guys so much for listening and hearing me out. I am very curious to hear your thoughts and opinions on Ticketmaster's news and what you guys think might happen to live events next year in 2021. Here is the hoping that we can all return to our normal lives and things can be done safely and the live event industry can come back booming, because my heart goes out to every single person who is out of work right now and all of the fans and everybody involved. So I want nothing more than to have them come back, but we have to be safe about it first. So please give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And if you are new here, I would love it if you would hit the subscribe button. Come join the family, come hang out, check out my podcast, Rave Culture Cast, that comes out every single Wednesday. And if you guys wanna read these articles, sources will be listed down below along with all of my information, social media handles, and all that fun stuff. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys.